We are the Malta Eurovision Song Contest 2023, and with us are four legends that have represented Malta at Eurovision. Let's start with Moira, 1994, with More Than Love.
1994, with More Than Love, with Chris.
And then we got Paul Giordimaina.
Yeah, that was with Giorgina, 91, in
and
Rome.
Could it be?
Could it be, yeah.
Mike Spiteri?
Yes, that was 1995, back in Ireland, and the song was called Keep Me In Mind.
And?
On again, off again, Ludwig, from Ludwig and Julie. Istanbul 2004.
Fantastic. Now, let's talk about your role here at the Malta Eurovision Song Contest. Now, you are the mentors. Now, what exactly are you doing in this contest?
Okay, yeah. I'll start. We're not exactly mentors, we're like consultants. That's the proper word. We have like a dual role, you know, that is taking care of the musical side from PBS, because PBS are very able to do productions, but we are pushing to when there are musical items involved, you know, and they give us all the strength to help them. On the other side, we are the link between PBS and the singers, and we'll help them. You know, we all won this contest. We all know the tension that entails this. So we're helping them in every way, and we are very much happy because we're very well received.
So how did you get into having this job?
Well, it's not exactly a job. It's something we do for other artists that are participating in this Eurovision. Remind you that we didn't have this kind of consultancy or whatever, but we are doing our best to see our artists happy on stage and comfortable to sing the song and everything around them.
What were your biggest challenges in being the consultants for this show?
Well, there were a few, to be honest. I think, having said that, although we have been a lot of help to the singers, because in previous years, if there were things, there were issues that weren't solved, we were here like a bridge to solve them for them. You know what I mean? This is what we were here for. Whether it's enhancing their composition, whether it's issues with certain rules and regulations, you know, we together as a team, we tried to make it work. And, you know, somehow
we make it
happened.
Better.
So, you know, it happened. So it's great.
Now, Malta had the X Factor before for a couple of years, and now back to the national final format. So what do you think is the better option to do, Ludwig?
No, I think it's the national final. Obviously, I mean, we have moved towards the Maltese national final, and then the song, actually the Maltese song for Europe. So we have once again the two main festivals, the national one with our own language, and the Eurovision, which artists even freely to choose. Mm-hmm. So if they would like to perform it with our own mother language, they can do so as well. So, but I think, speaking of X Factor and Got Talent, yes, we have some artists even this year from the franchise. So it's been good. But I think what we as a team did is a combination. We tried as much as not leaving the legendary artists out. Mm-hmm. Out. So we've got some of the legendary artists back in. We've got those who know their craft really well, and then we've got those who came from the X Factor. Mm-hmm. So it's a complete holistic process,
which is very good, I think.
The Eurovision is different from X Factor, where the X Factor is based solely on the artist singing a cover version. Here it is an original song, specifically written, and when the judges vote and when the people vote, they're judging on the artist and the song. After all, this is the Eurovision Song Contest.
We're looking for a complete package, we're looking for a complete ready-to-go artist.
Now, Malta has in the rules of the competition that they can always change the song once the artist has been selected. Do you think this is right to do that?
I don't think it's happening this year, though.
I don't think
it's happening. It has changed. This year definitely is not happening.
No, I don't agree with that.
Whoever wins with the song being performed tonight, on Saturday, final, they will keep the song. It's going to be the song representing the country.
I think what happened with previous year, the artist, the winner, was contracted with a particular label, and they insisted that they take over. Of course, we talked with PBS that this shouldn't be the case anymore, and as far as we know, it won't happen again. As far as we know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now you're all four were on the Eurovision stage in your years.
Yeah.
I think the only one where Ludwig, you had a backing track, and you were all singing with an orchestra.
70 piece live orchestra in Cork.
Wow.
And 70 piece live orchestra in Dublin. Yeah.
Wow. But are these changes that you welcome to have a backing track, or what other changes do you like or dislike in the contest?
No, I don't like the fact that they changed to a backing track now. I remember Chris saying it's like karaoke.
It is, but it's a different concept nowadays with the new technology and the new comings of this.
Yes, but you can't compare it to a live orchestra. It doesn't even start, you know what I mean? No.
23,
but I think
2000.
You all agree that Eurovision now has strayed on to more show than
the song.
So, which, agree or not, I leave it up to the individual.
The likability, you know? The likability factor with the audience, mm-hmm. With the story behind the artist. It's like the X Factor thing.
Yeah.
It's like the X Factor thing. So. The package has completely changed.
Basically, they turned the song into a spectacle.
Okay, indeed.
I old school. I mean, I prefer the orchestra.
Definitely.
Even I prefer the orchestra.
I prefer the life feel.
The life feel,
human.
Exactly.
Ludwig, for you, because you did have the backing track.
No, I would prefer the orchestra. I would prefer the orchestra.
Nice.
Yes. Wow. I mean, music is something life.
Mm-hmm.
Is something. It comes from the heart. When there's a backing track, you're also limited to express yourself.
Sorry?
Once you're with an orchestra, there's the life feel, which you can't express. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
So once you're with an orchestra, the feel can change.
Mm-hmm.
On the contrary, when you're singing to a backing track, you must be very specific.
Exactly. Last question, as being the consultant, the mentor, this one of the 24 songs will represent Malta at Eurovision this year. Now, each of you, I will ask, who is the best to send to?
I don't think we have an answer for
I'm
that.
I'm sorry, I don't think we're going to take that responsibility. Forget it.
Can I ask you something? Because you are the interviewer.
I think the 24 contestants. The 24 contestants
will win.
All of them.
Can I ask you something?
One of the 24 contestants will win.
Have you enjoyed this interview with us?
Definitely, much.
Rock on!
Rock on, fantastic. Thank you very much, guys, for talking to us. Thank
you. Pleasure is ours. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.